The gangers of House Goliath are well renowned for their huge vat-bred muscular frames and repurposed industrial gear that they carry into battle. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint one of these gangers in the colour scheme of the Iron Lords, which is the scheme that you can see on the Necromunda Underhive box. Now, whilst we are going to be focusing on painting one ganger, by following the methods and techniques we're going to show you, you'll be able to paint your entire gang. So without further ado, let's get started. When you're painting your House Goliath gangers, should you need any reference, you might want to download the Citadel Paint app, because we're actually going to be using some of the colour swatches that appear in it to paint our miniature. Specifically, we're going to be using medium flesh, warm brown, dirty metal, and also red as well. So you can see it's just handy reference whilst you're painting your miniatures. Now, for the undercoat colour for this miniature, I've chosen to go for Mechanica Standard Grey Spray, and you can see my models here ready. It's been sprayed with that colour. It's a fantastic starting point for all the colours we're going to be using to paint this miniature. Now, the first paint we need for it is Eshin Grey, and as always, remember to give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour, and I'm going to be applying this using a medium base brush. Now, throughout this video, I'm going to be using a palette, and I recommend you do the same, because doing so allows you lots of control over your paint. It means that by putting some on here, I can add a little bit of water to the mix, which is really important. It thins the paint down and makes it go a little bit further, and also it dries smoother as well, and it's less likely to clog up any detail. So you want to thin it down to about this kind of point before you start to apply it, and make sure your brush isn't overloaded with it as well. And when you're ready, the details you're looking to paint here are the trousers, so just along here. You also want to paint the boots, and if your model's got any grenades, you want to be sure to paint the heads of these as well. Once you've finished with the Eshin Grey, you're ready to move on to a much brighter colour, because the next paint we're going to add is Mephiston Red for all the red details. And there's a few of these. We've got the armour, then some stripes in the trousers, and also the weapons as well. Now, we're going to be applying this using a medium layer brush, because this has a bit more control to it than the medium base brush did. So again, you still want to use your palette to make sure your paint's thinned down with a little bit of water, and so it's flowing really easily. And then just make sure your brush isn't overloaded, and just twist the bristles like this to bring them to a nice tip. Now, for the details of painting, like I said, the first one that we need to do is the armour, and there's a few armour plates on the miniature, but for all these, you just need to block in the whole area like this. Now, a much finer area to paint is on the trousers, and that's these red stripe designs we have here, so just as neatly as you can, just start picking these details out like this. Now, the final detail to paint with the Mephiston Red is going to be on the gun, and you want to paint the main casing of it just like this. And once you paint this colour, should you see any of the Mechanica Standard Grey undercoat showing through, don't worry about it, just let this coat dry and apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. With our red blocks in, we're now ready to move on to the next colour, and in fact the next few colours all follow along with the same technique as what we've just done here, so we're going to run through those quickly for you now. First of all, we need lead belcher for painting all the silver details, such as armour trim and also details on the gun, but then we're going to move on to Balthazar gold for the details that are bronze. Now with that done, we're going to add some Mournfang brown, and this is for all the leather straps, and finally we need corn red, and this is for the hair, but also some pipes that are on the body as well. But we're going to be starting out with lead belcher, which I'm once again going to be applying with my medium layer brush, but it's a good idea to have a small layer brush on hand for this one, just to get some of those finer details. Now, as before, be sure to thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth like this, and be sure not to overload your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting in these details. And there are quite a few here. Now, the biggest one really is painting the trim of the armour, because there's quite a lot of this to do, but you can see it's raised up, so long as you're really gentle with your brush, you can get a nice straight line of those details very easily. Now, for other details you want to paint in, you've got things like skull designs here, there's a few details on the grenades, there's also lots of detail on the gun, and there's a collar just around here as well, so be sure to pick all these out. If you need any reference, there's some great pictures on the back of the box that will help guide you through it. Once you've finished applying the silver, you're ready to move on to Balthazar gold for all the bronze details. And for this, you want to paint the grips of the grenade, so just along here. But also, this colour's great for breaking up any large areas of silver. So for example, on the back here, we've got this mechanical stuff up here. What you can do is add some Balthazar gold just to make it a little bit more visually interesting. The next colour we need is Mournfang brown, and this time I recommend applying it with a small layer brush. Now you're looking at straps like this, but really take your time and be as neat as you can, especially with straps such as the one here just underneath the armour, which are a little bit tricky to get to. So really take your time with this step. And finally, we need corn red to paint in the hair, but also there's some small tubes to paint in this colour as well. And there's just two coming from the collar, so one just around here, and there's also two coming from the back harness as well. Now that we've finished applying all those colours, we're ready to shade them. And all these colours can actually use the same shade all at once. So we're going to use Agrax Earth Shade to do this. Now we're going to be applying quite a lot, so I'm going to go for a medium shade brush to apply it. It's a really good size for the kind of area you want to cover here. And what you should do is still use your palette to get some shade on here, because this way you can control exactly how much you're applying at once. To begin with, you want quite a lot on your brush, and all you do is just start painting this all over the detail on your miniature, and you'll see it runs directly into that recessed detail and gives the model loads of depth. Now it does take a little bit of time to dry, so be sure to leave the miniature for about half an hour once you're done. And as it's drying, just keep an eye on it to see if the shade's running towards the bottom of the miniature. It will tend to pool around the model's feet, and if you see a large amount of it appearing there, just move away the excess paint with your brush. The shade is now completely dry, and you can see it's made a massive difference to the miniature. And with that done, we can move on to the next step now, which is to paint in all the skin. Now the first step for painting the skin is to base coat all of it using Bugman's Glow. I'm going to be starting out with a medium layer brush for this, but you will need a small layer brush as well, because some of the details are quite small and tricky to get to, so you need lots of control for that. So remember to use your palette in helping with that control, as always thinning it down with a little bit of water so it's flowing smoothly, so like this. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start blocking in these details. So I'm going to start on the face here, just making sure I get an even coat all over it. If you can still see some of the undercoats showing through, then just apply that second thin coat to get a solid finish. But you can see some of the finer details, such as down there, just on the top of the muscles, getting to that detail is a great place for a small airbrush. And all of these muscles as well, you just do exactly the same thing, just being as neat as you can as you go around the details that you've painted so far. With that skin base coated, we're now ready to shade it, and for this we need Reichland Flesh Shade. Now, unlike the shade earlier, we need to be much more focused about it this time. We only want to get it on the skin, so I'm going to be applying it using my medium layer brush again and the small layer brush on hand just for those finer details. Now, use your palette like before just to make sure that your brush isn't overloaded, so just use a palette there like that, and once you've got the right amount on your brush, all you've got to do is start painting this onto the skin, and you'll see straight away it settles nicely in all that recessed detail. The shade is now completely dry, and we're ready to move on to the next step, which is to really brighten up the skin and start to bring out those details. We're going to do a layer of Cadian Flesh Tone first of all for this, and again I'm going to be applying it with my combination of both a medium layer and a small layer brush, the small layer brush for those finer details where you need more control. But use your palette as always to help with that control, again thinning your paint down with some water so it's flowing really smoothly. And then the real important thing here is to make sure that you don't overload your brush. So you can use some tissue to get rid of excess paint. You want to get the bristles together nicely like that. Now for this step, what you're looking to do is to paint almost all of the skin, except for the areas where you had a lot of shade settle. So let's go with the face, that's a great example there. You can see how the shade settled in all the features around there. So what I'm going to do is paint these raised parts where there's less of that shade. So we've got the nose just there, and then just on the top of the mouth just there. We've got that recess there and the crease going onto his cheek, so I'll just leave that and then paint on this side here like that. And you can see already this is really starting to make all those features on the face stand out nicely. Now the same is true on the muscles, so on the arm here for example, I'd paint these flatter parts such as along here, and then where we've got that shade in the recess there, I just skip that part and carry on painting on the other side like that. That layer is now applied, and you can see it's really bringing out all the detail of the skin and even the expression on the face. And what we need to do now is just carry on bringing that out a little bit further by adding a highlight of Kislev Flesh. Now this I'm going to be applying just with my small layer brush because we want lots of control this time. So use your palette to make sure you've got that control. Again, be sure to thin your paint down with a little bit of water so it's flowing very smoothly, and then just twist your bristles like this whilst dragging the brush along to bring those bristles to a fine point, and also to make sure the brush isn't overloaded. And then what we're looking to do is to pick out all the sharpest features on the skin. So the face is again a great example of this. The nose is an obvious one down the centre, so what I'll do is just paint a small amount of this colour just down the middle there. But then what we want to do is follow all these raised features. So we want to follow along the cheek just around here. And then, of course, we've got the chin as well, so we want to be sure to pick that out with a small amount of the colour down there as well. We've got areas like the top lip just along here, so you see all these bits I'm picking out are just bringing out the expression on the face a little bit further. Now on the muscles, because they're curved, what you want to do is just paint a line of this colour towards the top of each area like this, along areas where the light would catch, so just a fine highlight like that. And with that highlight applied, the skin is now complete, and we can move on to painting the next detail, which is to go back to the red armour, because the shade earlier, whilst it has given a lot of depth, it has also dulled it down quite a bit, and we need it to be brighter. So we're going to go back to Mephiston Red and reapply it, only a little bit differently this time. This is going to be a lot like the Cadian Fleshstone we applied earlier. We're looking to layer over most of it, but to avoid the recessed areas where the shade settled the most. So again, be sure to thin your paint down so you've got lots of control over it, and when you're ready, I'll paint the chest plate, because it's a great example of what to do here. We're looking to paint over most of the flat area like this, but you can see where it meets the silver and that little recessed bit around there, shade has settled quite strongly in those parts. So we're going to avoid that part there like that. So just paint up close to it, but don't go right into that recess there like that. But for the flat parts, you just want to apply this all over them. Now that we've got a brighter finish to all those Mephiston red details once more, we're ready to begin highlighting all the red this time. So this will include all the corn red details. We need Evilson Scarlet for all of these, and we're going to be applying this using small layer brush, because now we're going to do a technique that's called edge highlighting. To do it, you once again need to use your palette to get your paint ready, because it's really important you have lots of control here, because we're picking out very fine details now. We're looking to pick out anything that's a sharp edge or a sharp corner. So the chest plate is a great example here, because you can see there's a sharp corner just on there. And there's one on this side too. So what you do is, as neatly as you can, just follow along that corner with a line of this colour there like that, just to pick out this detail and make it stand out a little bit more. Now we also need to highlight this stripe going around the trousers, so for this you just need to follow it round once again as neatly as you can there like that. And we also need to highlight the hair at this stage. Now if you use the side of your brush and very lightly start running along like that, you can see the brush can only catch those raised parts of the detail, so this way you get a really nice highlight really quickly and simply. Now that we've highlighted all those red details, we can move on to highlighting all the remaining colours using much the same technique. First of all, we're going to need Dawnstone to highlight the trousers, the boots, and also the grenades, but then we'll move on to Stormhost Silver to highlight all the silver details. After that, we need Psychorax Bronze for all the bronze detail, and then Scrag Brown for all that brown leather. Finally, we need a very small amount of Screaming Skull, and this is going to be to paint in his teeth. But we're going to be starting out with Dawnstone, and I'm going to be applying this like before using my small layer brush, because like with the red, we're looking to pick out all those sharpest edges and details with this colour. So once your paint is ready, we'll start out with the fabric of the trousers. Now for this, you're looking at the tops of the creases, so you can see we've got some ones just along there. All I'm going to do is just very carefully paint a line of this colour following along the top of those creases there, like that. Now for the boots, you want to go around the sharpest point, so you're looking at lines such as just along the end there, like that. But then, we've also got these grenades. Now for the grenades, you're going to want to look for the corners, so we're just going to follow along that corner just there like that. On this rounded grenade, we'll also want to paint just a small line along the top, like that. Next, we're ready to highlight all the silver details using Stormhost Silver. Once again, using a small layer brush to really carefully follow along all those edges. So just be as neat as you can as you follow this step. Next, we can highlight all the bronze details using Psychorax Bronze. Once again, following along all the sharper edges, such as this detail I've got here on the shotgun. Now for the grenade handles, what you do is just paint a line, just a single line, running down the side of them, just like that. Next up, we need Scrag Brown to highlight all the brown leather straps. And once again, just use a small layer brush to follow along all the edges of these details. And finally, paint in the teeth using Screaming Skull. And of course, just be as careful as you can when you're doing this detail. Once you've finished applying those highlights, the miniature is just about finished. We're at a stage though where you can choose to add a few further details if you want to, and there's some subtle weathering effects we're going to do now. Now to do this, first of all, we're going to add some little bits of rust, and we're going to use an unusual technique to do this. What you need is Scrag Brown once more, but what we're going to do this time is thin it down quite a lot so it's very runny. So you just want to use a small airbrush to get a small amount of this paint and put it onto your palette like that, and then get a brush full of water and mix them together. So you see this way I've got a very thin version of the paint there like that. And what you do is just get some on your brush, not too much, and then just look for some areas of silver metal where you can paint this in to be rust. A great example will be on the back here, just on the elbow. What you do is just run some of this into the recesses there like that for a little subtle amount of rust. I recommend you don't go overboard on it. In cases of weathering like this, less is often more. Another great place to do it would be on little rivets such as just on the heel down here. Once you're happy with that rust effect, if you want to, you can also add some verdigris in the form of a paint called Nylac Oxide. Now, Nylac Oxide looks a lot like a shade, but actually it behaves a little bit differently and has a slightly chalky texture to it. You don't need very much, so I recommend again using your small layer brush to apply it, and what you want to do is use your palette to control how much you have on your brush at once, and again, you really don't need very much. So just get a small amount loaded up there like that. And then what you're looking to do is to paint this into recesses on bronze details. So on our shotgun just here, you can see we've got this bronze panel here with these rivets. What I can do is just paint a small amount of this underneath each one like that. And this is a great way of just adding a little bit of colour to these details. Now, once you've done this, your miniature is ready to have its base painted. And I recommend you paint your entire Necromunda gang's bases in the same way so that they all match and in a way that matches your scenery collection. And with the base fully painted, this House Goliath ganger is complete, ready to descend into the Underhive to earn fame, glory, and of course, credits. So when painting your House Goliath gang, and in fact with any Citadel miniatures, we always recommend that you use a palette, because doing so allows you to thin your paints down with a little bit of water. Doing this, you'll find, will give you much more control over your paints. Now when you're applying the paint to the miniature, apply it as multiple thin coats, because doing so will again give you more control, but also it'll give you a smooth finish to your miniature, and also keep those details nice and sharp. Finally, it takes practice, but neatness really is the key. The neater you are, the better your miniatures are going to look. So always remember to take your time and practice bringing the brush bristles to a fine tip. So we really hope you guys have enjoyed this video and learned something from it, and have fun painting your Goliath gangers. And well, we'll see you all again very soon.